Hello and welcome to Key Factors, presented by theraceguide.com.au as we have a look at the car this week at Royal Randwick, hopefully under some clear and sunny skies. Plenty of best bets coming your way. We've got Group 3 racing. We've got the very rich Inglis Millennium race day to get through as well. And Mike, tell you what, mate, you have a look at this card on a Wednesday, you see all these short price favourites, and I know one thing on this show, we always look for value, so I'm expecting good things from you, mate.
Yeah, I usually love to lay away, I usually love the big odds runners, $10 plus, but it's going to be very, very hard on Saturday. Some very strong horses racing, even those short price runners as well, Stu.
Yeah, very, very true, and we've got some ranging from about $1.35. And look, it's not all about the prices this week, Mike. Obviously, we've got some class horses resuming this week. Keen to have a look at some of these in the yard. Ole Kirk, obviously Group 1 winner. I'm keen to see him go. How about you, mate? Who's looking forward to the autumn?
Yeah, keeping that Golden Rose form going. North Pacific looks like a little Lonro in the mounting yard. He's so, so strong late. His barrier trial form, not so sure. We'll see what you think in the key factors.
Yeah, little Lonro. Big call there to get things going. Let's have a look now at the card of... have a look at the conditions this week, obviously, to start with, Mike. And, well, it's warm here Thursday, warm Friday, but a chance of some rain there on Sunday, Saturday.
Some natural rain in the lead-up, some nice drying weather. The rail stribbling's perfect, but there's just a little bit of a chance of rain from 12 o'clock on Saturday, so keep an eye on that. We're playing soft 5 tonight, but it could be anywhere from good 4 to soft 6 if the rain does come.
Yeah, very, very true. Okay, so have a look at the weather there. And, Mike, it's a really hard card to assess, isn't it? We've only got to pick 5 races, and, well, we said so many of these races with short price favourites, but it's where the classy horses are.
Yeah, I think the Inglis Millennium for 2-year-olds would have broken the computer. Shoot, that was a very hard race with form lines from everywhere, one to start each. So we'll dodge that one. We'll get a tip later. But race 3... 6, 7, 3 short-priced Hawks runners. Which ones do we like? Which ones don't we like? And I love the Randwick Mile Race 8 and Race 9. Got to do them too.
Yeah, it's pretty much the Hawks short-priced favourite day, isn't it? And Race 3, the Heineken Handicap over the 1,000 metres. That is where we are going to start. So let's have a look at the shortest-priced favourite of the day as we have a look at the market here. And wow, this horse, Mike, it is going to be $1.35 come Saturday. That was what the odds were early on Thursday, but it's still there. Written Beauty, $1.35. 5 starts, 4 wins. It's trialed well. The punters are used to the tomato sauce odds for this horse. $1.80, $1.70, $1.85 and $1.45. They've been keen to back her. Space Boy on the second line at $5. We'll roll along. Swamp Late last start over the 1,200 metres. We've got Zanaya, $12 resuming. Liked its trials. Dual Fresh winner and just missed first up during a wet winter campaign. Last preparation. And then out to Royal Witness at $14 off a let up, Mike. But Written Beauty, $1.35. They've got to be pretty good to be warranting those odds going around on Saturday.
And purely based on her form running so far, it looks like madness. But then you look at her profile, what a beautiful type she is, how progressive she is. And then you look at this barrier trial, Stew, and you kind of think the way she beats them, maybe they're horses like maiden horses, class one horses, but nope, these are group one performing horses like Dirty Work. She gets out 5 lengths in front. The thing this horse has got is plenty of early speed, and she does fight late, Stu.
Yeah, okay, so she fights late. What's she up against? I mean, we're going to see another replay after this latest. So the big question here, what has she beaten so far in her racing career?
Yeah, she produces a rating so far, she wins just, but you've got to say there's 2, 3, 4, 5 lengths in the tank, man.
All right, well, she is again up against a few horses. One of those, of course, is Starboy, Mike. So we're having a look at a Muswellbrook barrier trial just a couple of weeks ago. So from Muswellbrook to town, we don't mind finding some of these horses.
Yeah, and these are maidens behind her as well, some of them. So this big boy Starboy, I think he's an underrated horse. He's had a tie-back surgery, so his last couple of runs maybe weren't at his best. His best form is a couple of lengths off Dirty Work, which lines up with the barrier trial we just saw. A strong horse, an underrated horse, but maybe a yard watch first up.
Okay, so there's a look at 2 replays. We've got a shorty in the first race we're looking at, race number 3. So let's see how far potentially Written Tycoon could be on top, Mike. But for form... Written Beauty. We'll go back a step there. But only a length here on the form.
If it was Written Tycoon, we wouldn't have long enough on the page there, but she's just in front for form so far.
All right, let's see how far ahead this favourite could potentially get here with the key factors, Mike. But look, it hasn't skipped ahead early on.
No, Space Boy likes 1,000 metres. He can give some cheek.
All right, so Space Boy leveling up here to Written Beauty. What about the speed map here, Mike? Only the each way, you know, field.
Yeah, small field, and hopefully jockeys can find their spot.
Okay, so it's still just these two, Mike. So, Written Beauty favourite backers will be wanting to see gold, and they get that here with Progression because everyone's talking about this horse.
Boy, is there edge though? Massive, massive upside. Should be better than these horses. The Progression is huge. Star Boy with the tie-back surgery can improve. Like I said, Yard Watch, not always at his best first up.
Okay, the key factors viewers had to wait there till the end, but it did skip ahead the favourite from Space Boy, then a couple of lengths back to the rest of the field there, Mike. And, well, as these first few races are going to suggest, we're just going to have to weigh up odds. It might be on top on the ratings. It might be on top on the key factors. But the big question is, are we going to be backing them come Saturday?
Well, do you like speculative bets that need to improve at $1.35 to win by a couple of lengths, Jude? Oh,
no, thanks.
That is the question. I don't mind her, really. I think she's going to lead. She's going to be so hard to run down. She's got such massive upside. So we're going to tip her. And hopefully we get slightly better odds. And Space Starboy is one that can improve. His trial was pretty good leading into this with the tie-back surgery.
Okay, so Written Beauty, the best bet. Starboy, potentially a little bit of value there. Race number three to get things started at Randwick on Saturday. And now we are up to race number six, 1,200 metres, the Eskimo Prince Stakes at Group 3 level. And, well, the speed will be on here. We've got the face for Nelly, Belieber. They'll all be rolling forward. Could that set it up for some of the classy runners here, including North Pacific? Good to see this horse back on the track. Some good early money as well. $2.15, another Hawks favourite here. Brazen Bow Colt resuming. A head bobber in the Golden Rose at the end of last preparation. Peltzer on the second line, $4.80. The So You Think Colt, it's resuming as well. And obviously those two big wins last preparation. Of course, the face, $7.50, Mike. In form, backed up. So good run in the Gosford Guineas with an all-the-way win here last start. We've got Prague at $8, a reduced choice colt resuming. Got home nicely in his trial. And then out to Tommy Gold, the Sacred Falls colt, who ran a couple of gallant seconds last preparation and coming off a nice trial here, Mike. But North Pacific, we're into another short price Hawks runner.
A very, very good horse. Looks good in the mounting yard. Fights hard every single time. Let's have a look at a decent race to look at last preparation. It kind of had to freshen up into this run, the prep run for the Golden Rose, and wasn't maybe quite wound up at its best. It gets a weight turner against Peltzer on Saturday, and it still beats him home. It's a strong finish, and it should love the strong tempo on Saturday.
Yeah, okay, so a nice chance to sort of get these horses together. We know they've done that before, and, well, that's the form lines we've got to look at here, isn't it?
And just love the way he flattens out. The tempo on Saturday is the big factor. If the rain does come, he loves it as well.
Okay, yeah, that's a good point. Okay, so have a look at all those conditions. And, well, another horse that's there in the market, as we saw, Mike, is Prague. It was an expensive yearling. It's performed so far to date. And one thing we've found out about this horse is it's a trier as well.
Yeah, you never know what's going to happen between preps, but we think North Pacific might have Peltzer covered by two or three lengths based on quite a few runs. But Prague's an interesting one. Two preps ago, very strong, mixing it with the Group 1 horses. Last prep, not quite up to its best in Melbourne. The first run, okay at Flemington, and didn't quite get around Caulfield. Next start, new stable, Annabelle Neesham, great yard, looks after their horses, always strong to the line. I love the way I got to the line there,
Steve. Yeah, okay, importantly, back to Sydney as well, back to home base. So let's have a look here now, Mike, in the Eskimo Prince Stakes to get things started with all the form. We saw a few of these in the spring, and, well, North Pacific, it's got that, it's classy.
At the set weights, they've got so much ground to make up, Steve.
Okay, well, let's see if anyone can do it. Track distance and conditions, a few of these at value, getting a kicker.
Prague back to Sydney could help. Tommy Gold, if the soft track holds up, it would help. And Never Talk, definitely soft track, 1,200 metres would help for her too.
Okay, yep, a mountain of class to make up there for Never Talk. And, well, North Pacific on the speed map here, Mike. Explain this one. A lot of pace in the race, it gets a good sit.
Should just trail the strong tempo and absolutely love the tempo. Global Quest gets in a decent spot. It's formed two preps, goes okay. Last prep a few lengths behind though.
The favourite backers, they'd be loving seeing this, Mike, but Progression, well, it can't go any further ahead, but a few of these can.
I think Prague can improve this prep, just guessing how much. The face, he's getting better behaved in the yard on the racetrack as well. He's improving all the time.
All right, so North Pacific out by a couple of lengths there. So favourite in race number three, a favourite in race number six has streeted ahead here. $2.15, it's the same game, isn't it, Mike? We've got a favourite here, short price. The other favourites, well, they're not too far. Well, they are a few lengths behind here, Mike. Is it purely a class factor in this race?
Three-horse race, and the speed map might rule out Peltzer. I think he's drawn wide. He won't quite get into the controlling spot that he wants. So you're left with North Pacific and you're left with Prague. Geez, the odds were good on Wednesday for
and you're
North
left
Pacific.
With a $2.15 shot.
Yeah, but I don't know. He's so well back. He's such a strong horse, such a strong finish, and such a thin race. And Prague strong to the line as well.
Yeah, he looks a good horse in the making there. North Pacific there for us with Prague the value. That's two down this weekend at Randwick. Plenty more after the break coming your way. Well, welcome back to Key Factors, presented by theraceguide.com.au. We are having a look at the card at Royal Randwick this weekend, and we are up to race number 7. It is the Inglis Sprint over the 1,200 metres, and we're tipped both Hawks runners, both shorties in the first two races we've looked at. We've got another one here, $2.40. It's Ole Kirk resuming here. Some speed again in the race through Malkovich and the Bopper. But Ole Kirk scratched last week for this. Chase Rothfire, then the two big Group 1 wins. This horse is all class. Dame Giselle on the second line, $3.70, resuming here. One thing we know about this horse is the drier the better, $3.70. The Bopper, $6. Keen Fresh, but obviously it tired, but it'll be out in front here. Prime Star, $12, resuming off some nice trials as well. And then out to Malkovich, Mike, but Ole Kirk, the dual Group 1 winner, he's back.
And when the pressure goes on, he soaks it up and just keeps coming to the Golden Rose and see just how classy this horse is at his best. Obviously, North Pacific's in this run as well, and Peltzer gets back off a strong tempo, gets to the outside, and rips home. Stu, love this horse.
Yeah, well, that's it, isn't it, Mike? It's making up ground. Where is it going to get at on the weekend? That's probably going to be the big question, but we know it can rip off his way home.
It could look very similar on Saturday, probably fall back the rails is where he maps. He'll need the right split at the right time, so a big ride for James Mack. Hopefully, the strong tempo enables a split at the right time.
All right, so there's some nice form lines there. Of course, Mike, one of these it's up against this weekend has been a favourite of ours on the show from the Spring Carnival. And Dame Giselle got its own way out in front this day. And, well, look, this is on a soft track, Mike, but you've said all along this horse, it just loves it dry.
Loves it dry and loves it second up, usually. But there is a $600,000 first prize carrot to get it wound up. Look, this was an okay win. It was a tough win. I guess it was dominant at the end because when it was challenged, it held on. Thermosphere's come out of run recently and rated around the mid-80s mark, which is a solid rating against this field, but maybe not as good as the favourite.
Yeah, all right. Yeah, you're very true, isn't it? All this prize money around, you think they're going to be wound up for it, but obviously a big yard watch this race with so many resuming. Let's have a look now at all the key factors here to see if we can steer you into the winner. And well, all that Group 1 form, Mike, Ole Kirk is out in front.
He's probably the best horse in the race, and his form last prep is definitely the best.
Okay, well, we know Dame Giselle had a good preparation as well, Mike, and we've already spoken about it a few times. The track distance and conditions here.
Maybe 1,200 metres gives her a slight edge, but she needs to be fit. Rocketing by up in distance helps, and Rule of Law helps, but I don't think that form line's good enough.
Okay, we've got a $2.40 favourite, Ole Kirk, the map. This is the interesting piece.
Just before you step in and put a big bet down, Ole Kirk maps to be four back the rails. Ooh. Dame Giselle maps to be possibly three wide, no cover. At those odds, I'm not sure, Stu.
Okay, so there's a chance it could look ugly, but progression, Mike. These horses, they're all back into it. They've all got gold.
And just the one question is Dame Giselle first up. She's often not at her best.
All right, so that's a horse that could improve into the preparation. Ole Kirk, you're saying, might be ready to go. It's got the form. It has only got a one-length win, though, there, as we see on all the key factor ratings there, Mike. The Bopper, not too far behind, $6. It's got some race fitness as well. Dame Giselle's right there, but Ole Kirk, another price play, mate. Another Hawks runner, $2.40, and we're not three from three, are we?
Well, I don't know what to do. The rain's not going to come, so the Bopper might not be advantaged. Bella Nipotina's more a tight track, soft track horse. Bella Malkovich will knock up. Prime Star is just okay. So I think if he gets out, it could be three in a row or three favourites in a row for Hawks. Ole Kirk just needs a luck at the right time. Decide at home whether the price is good enough for you. I'm not sure yet.
Disappointing for key factors, mate. I think the punters are looking for value. We haven't given them any yet. We are three races into our five.
Just trying to be popular, mate. Come on.
All right. Race number 8, a mile. You like these sort of races as well. Let's have a look at the market here. Oh, mate, we've got another shorty. $1.70. Money has come again. All-time legend. Big wins to start his preparation. Didn't get a crack when he had to sit latest. I doubt they'll make that mistake again. It's going to go forward here. Mount Popper, $3.80, resuming. Lovely trial. We know this horse has got a lot of potential. Order again, $7. Huge win fresh. Closed well last time after looking a little lost there late. And, of course, shared ambition, $8, resuming. Nice trials. This horse we know can get home at his best, Mike, but all-time legend, took the sit last start. Where is it going to be this weekend?
Well, it looked very, very good in the yard first up and second up, so whether it can keep progressing is the question. Obviously, one with favours early in the preparation. And then this start, I know it was unlucky, but it kind of got some favours as well. It was a near rails on pace bias this day, and it got the box seat, which is the best spot to be, but got held up to about 150, 175 metres out with a big weight and came again late. Probably unlucky,
but was in the right spot, Stu, so he could lay him, maybe.
Okay, so on that day, I wonder what we gave it for a speed map, because it was just in there, in behind, and...
You never know.
Well, it's going to be in front this weekend.
Some people love the box seat, some people call it the coffin, Stu.
And it can do that to you. I think we were on that day as well. Let's have a look now.
Not me, mate, not me, that was you.
Okay, order again, Herengowie, Sikandra about. A few of these have been racing just a couple of weeks ago, Mike. And, well, this is the listed Carrington. We're on a good track here, 1,400 metres. So can this distance help any of these?
Well, definitely the distance, and they all want a soft track. This is a firm track on pace bias this day. So once again, the on pace has dominated. Order again, solid through the line. Sikandra about in the yellow, not bad through the line. Second up after a let up. And Herengowie just winding up late after being jagged back early. Not the worst last you'll ever see.
All right, so a couple there that we could be having a look at later on, a few sneaky replays there, but it is a $1.70 favourite to start this race. All-time legend there, Mike, but Mount Popper, well, we know this horse has got progression, but it's got form as well.
I'm sick of talking about him after your scratch last week, so no replays for him, but he was very, very strong at the end of last prep.
Yeah, good point. We were strong on it last week as well. Speed map here, Mike. Here we go.
Well, that's a bit of a risk. 1,600 metres drying track from Mount Popper.
All right.
And I'll go straight into the speed map. This is the big kicker. All-time legend. Could lead on his own. If the rain doesn't come and he backs it off, big, big kicker for him.
Yeah, look, I was just excited for that. As soon as we talk about this race, it's all about the map. This horse is going to be out in front at a steady tempo, potentially, as you say. And, well, progression here, Mike. Where are we with a few of these?
How can you not get the order of the key factors right up to 4 years? Mount Popper, big, big upside. Sikandra Bad and Herengowie can improve into their prep.
All right, all-time legend, $1.70, only out by a length. Mount Popper, the second favourite right in behind. Mate, the market is just telling us that this is the way to go. That's the way the key factors have gone. But again, Mike, are your hands going into your pocket to put a big bet on all-time legend here based off that?
Not yet.
All right.
It all depends on the weather and the conditions and the bias. But if the track is firm and leaders are winning, $1.70 could be value, Stu, because it leads on its own and it can sprint. And some of these days won't be able to quicken with it from the 6 to the 4. So maybe it'll get a break. And Herengowie can box seat. If the rain does come, definitely a bet at big odds.
Okay, so some nice value there for the value bet. But Mike, best bet, $1.70. Mate, we've got one race left. I'm pretty sure we need some value. It is over the mile to finish things off in the last race of the day at Randwick. And let's have a look at this market. We've got Blazer Trail, $3.60. Got home well fresh. Sharp rise in trip here. The inside gate, a big query here. Skylab, $5. Built speed, ridden a long way out at Wyong Fresh. I like what I saw there. Down in the weights here at $5. We've got Zing, $9.50. Draws well. It's probably going to go forward. Dabari on the back up at $9.50. It's racing well. It's got to look to slot in from an awkward gate, though. And then out to Game of Thorns, $10. And Blondo, who's in good form as well. But Blazer Trail, Mike, $3.60. It's the favourite here in the last, but we don't have any shorties.
No, we don't. But we've got a favourite. I can tip it. Let's see what we do. Let's have a look at that favourite and see if we like it. Blazer Trail, very flashy, strong, solid son of Criterion. Has upside over a distance, resumed first up here up to okay trials. Did get a trail behind the winner, Tycoonus, so it was probably in a reasonable spot, but you have to like the way it got to the line late, Stu.
Absolutely, Mike, and you can only think second up, it's just going to improve as well.
Yeah, just that barrier one for a horse that doesn't really ping or quicken can always be a risk. It could be the coffin again.
Yeah, it's interesting to see a few of those this weekend with the inside gate. And, well, Salika wasn't in that part of the track this week, Mike, because this is day day. We're going back to Morfettville. Mate, I think I was on this day. I can't believe you've picked up this replay, mate. I was on it, some pretty big odds.
I've got nothing to say. Just keep going, mate. I know you backed it massive each way. What happened?
Didn't win.
Didn't
I know
win.
That.
Well, the horse,
it was a good race.
It was a good race. The horse that beat it won a couple of, just a week ago at Caulfield, rating okay. Its run last start was unlucky, I think. We had a little bit go each way, so she's going well.
All right, going well. Change of stables. We were on it the other week. Let's see if it factors, Mike. Let's have a look. Blazer Trail in the form. Hey, look at this. We've actually got a race on our hands here to finish.
Yeah, Blazer Trail form is okay, but not the best. Dabari off a wet track run that was solid. But Game of Thorns, 3 wide, no cover last start. And Salika, no luck last start. We're lighting them up.
Okay, nicely done. Let's have a look. Track distance and conditions here.
Drying conditions for Dabari is a risk. St. Covered Spirit, maybe soft track 16, maybe not quite as good. And Pitchfork has peaked at the mile before.
St. Covered Spirit has had no luck. Mike, it's had a lot of chances this preparation. You've tipped it many, many times. Speed map.
Well, on a Thursday night, the wide barriers of Game of Thorns and St. Covered Spirit don't look good. But if they are swooping out wide, They could be bets late.
Okay, all right, so a lot of gold across the page here. The mile, progression, a few of these up sharply in trip.
Well, that's why I think the favourite to the top of the market, Blazer Trail, decent upside, and Skylab, dominant last start, up in distance helps. But can it sprint against Saturday Grove?
All right, that is the question there. So the favourite's right in the money in terms of our ratings, but we did notice a couple down the page there. Mike Salika at $14, $3.60 favourite. I'm not letting you tip another favourite here in the last, Mike. There's been too many already.
No, not from Barrier 1 with potential storms and wants a dry track. So the good news is, Stu, that I'm not going to tip that, but I might be putting the mock on your favourite horse, Salika. Each way, big odds, goes forward. Very tough to run down.
All right, happy to go back for that in the last. That's some nice value. That's good to see Salika there. Well, look, there's five races. There's been a lot of favourites, but some value there in the last. Plenty more racing coming your way. We'll have a look at those after the break. Maybe did a bad, bad thing. Welcome back to Key Factors, presented by theraceguide.com.au. It's big racing at Royal Randwick this weekend, and one thing we just don't usually do is tip up all these favourites, Mike. Four out of five, you've gone the short way home. Maybe there's a big multi in the day for Saturday. I don't know what's going on, but there's other races, and there's more short price favourites, mate. And, well, I can see them on this page. Are you just going to load up on a multi or what?
No, I'm not doing a multi. It's not my style. Some of these depend on the conditions. Conglomerate. Got to be happy that starts, Stu.
Yeah,
White Barry, but very good trials at $8. Another one goes forward, hard to beat $2.50. Written Beauty goes forward, just wins $1.35. April Rain, I want to see it drift a little bit and then making ground at $2. Profiteer, not too wet at $1.75. North Pacific, any conditions hard to beat. Ole Kirk just needs luck. All-time legend wants it drier, maybe, compared to the field it's racing against. And maybe the only one we like, Stu, is your favourite girl, Salika.
Well, mate, racing just throws up these things sometimes, doesn't it? Maybe you just got to roll with it. They're bloody good horses on the weekend.
I'm not tipping against some of those horses. They're just too good.
All right, but when it comes to playing with $100, we're not going to have a multi, as you said, Mike. So there's a few of these horses that are resuming that you do like. One of those is your boy North Pacific, isn't
it? Yeah, I think so. It's a bit like Domino's on Saturday. Just the tab just wants one of them to get beaten. And we on Key Factors just want to pick the right one. It was the speed map was the factor for us. Less risk for North Pacific, plus the fact it can handle absolutely any conditions. If the rain comes, it's fine. Prague is the one I'm worried about, so I'll cover on him. And Salika, the only value we could find after half an hour of analysis, 25 each way at $14.
So you're saying that North Pacific is the best of the shorties?
I think on a Thursday night, it is. Yeah, it depends on pattern. I won't go into too much detail because I bore people, but on Thursday night's the best bet for us.
All right, we got that out of you. And, of course, we'll have a new charity segment in the coming weeks. But that's it from us. Head to theraceguide.com.au for all your feature profiling. Big racing this weekend at Royal Randwick. Hope you back a few of those shorties. Hope they all get home for you. And I hope you have a big profit.
Good luck with your all-up.